Hi yes, this is Raghavendra, English teacher. Today for 10 plus our topic is the breakwater. Okay. Actually the pond was very timid. So before going to know about the water, we just start the lesson with some of the story. There was a thick forest. In that forest there was a tiger. It was in search of its food. It came far away from its shelter, so now it was searching for its small shelter, but now it is getting very dark and they started raining heavily. So the tiger was going on and on for searching a little shelter. So after some time, after going some distance, it found some shelter in the forest nearby. So slowly, by with a sigh of relief, it reached the shelter, a thatched roof, and it just placed itself on the veranda, and it was getting a little sleep because it was very tired for searching in search of the food. So after resting itself, after some time, there was a big sound inside the shelter. It was very careful to hear the sound, what was coming from inside. Then a human voice heard inside, from inside the shelter. The voice said that the leap was very dangerous. In fact, I can caught a tiger in the forest by having this leap in my house, the voice said. Here the tiger thought about the leap, that it was very strong than itself. That means the tiger got some fear about the leap. It thought the leek was a dangerous animal and strong animal than the tiger. So after some time, it got into deep sleep. Okay, after resting some time, it heard a voice again, a human voice. And there was heavy blows on its shoulder, backside of its neck. And it got the very big blows by hitting on the legs and on its stomach. At the place of stomach, so it thought it was a little bit, even in the sleep, very drowsy, feeling very drowsy. So after getting awakened, it thought it was getting the blows from the leek animal only. It thought the leek was very dangerous animal, so that it felt about the leek, it was a dangerous animal and it is getting the blows from that animal only. Actually these blows were being given by the porter. Coming to the second part of the story, the porter once was living in a village nearby the forest. He had a donkey. One day it was escaping from the porter and it went into the forest. So in search of the donkey, the porter also came inside the forest, and he was a drunk at that time, and he was very angry for escaping the donkey from him. So in his anger, by having some drink, he was feeling very drowsy. So he did not find the difference between the donkey and the tiger. Slowly he reached the shelter where the tiger was resting. He was unable to notice the donkey and the tiger, what was it, on the veranda. So he just kept on to the back of the tiger, then he started blowing the tiger. Actually, the tiger thought it was the leek, a dangerous animal. A coincidental scene happened here by the writer. So, the tiger thought it was a leek, and it started, there was a rope just tied around his neck. Then, the porter started the pulling neck of the tiger with the help of the rope. Then It just stood up and started towards how the porter is giving the direction towards his home. Slowly, in the midnight, they reached their village, and the porter tied the what he felt actually his donkey and the tiger was tied up to the nearby tree in his village yard, in his house yard. Then he went inside and slept. After getting morning time, after waking up, the villagers thought that the tiger was tied to a nearby tree in the yard of the porter. they thought the potter was very brave. Actually, they feel about the potter, he was very brave. But some of the villagers called the potter outside. Then he came outside of his house and the villagers started praising him. He did not notice why the people are praising him. Because when he looked at the tiger, actually he was feeling it was a donkey. By noticing it, he felt it was his donkey, but actually it is a tiger. Then after looking at his donkey, actually not donkey, it was a tiger, he got fainted. So then he was unable to retrieve how the donkey becomes a tiger. Then it was, he was telling to the villagers, I did not get the tiger, I just bought my only donkey from the forest. The villagers even praised him for his honesty and the genuinity. Okay, after some years, the king of the country, had a meeting with his ministers. Okay, for the risk of being getting attacked by the neighboring country enemies. So one of the ministers said that he knows the potter, the brave potter. So okay, then the king called the potter to his palace and ordered him to go to the battlefield the next day. Even the potter did not know how to ride a horse and how to fight with the enemy in the battlefield. Then immediately he went, in the early morning he went into the went near the horse and started climbing up the horse. Actually his wife is also there. He asked his wife to tie the hands and legs to the horse's neck. In this meantime, the horse is waiting very eagerly for his new master. So after getting tied his hands to the horse's neck, the horse suddenly started running towards the enemy camp. It came out of the city gates and started towards the enemy's camp, where the enemy is not far away from the capital city. Then it started very rapidly. It was rushing towards the enemy's camp very fast. In the middle of the journey, the porter tried to just catch up some tree, a branch of some tree. Instead of stopping the horse, the branch of the tree came out of the roots. So there was now a tree's branch in his hand, one of the tree's branch in his hand, left hand, and he was riding the horse with his other hand. From far distance, the enemy's camp security guard observed the porter by carrying a tree, some of the tree and branch in his hand. He then went inside the camp of the soldiers. He shouted, "Run, run, save your lives. The enemy's soldier, the brave soldier, is coming up, but now we have to save ourselves. He was the man who brought the tiger with the bare hands from the forest." He said like this. He shouted like this. Then all soldiers split away. They scattered. They got some fear about the soldier who brought the tiger with the bare hands. So they just spread away. Even they escaped from the place. The king of the country just wrote a note, pardon by asking forgiveness for the enemy's king, and he also went away. The porter's horse came there and it stopped, and the porter took the letter from the camp and he then returned to the country. The king praised him a lot for escaping the enemy, for saving his country from enemy, and this brave soldier had never rode a horse again, and he received a lot of money and gold from the king's country. Okay, I think you have understood the lesson well. Just call me if you have any doubts. Thank you.